What can you do to keep yourself accountable? Or how can you just avoid all those pitfalls and triggers which just get you to that place? Well, first, it's important to know your why. So why would you keep yourself accountable? And for what purpose? So what would you achieve? Then what would keep you from getting out of that state, assuming that you did get into that state? I'm not talking about today about how to get into that state, but I do talk about if you are in that state, how to stay in there. So what can get you out of that state? Next, what will keep you in wherever you are going next? And which is likely an escape, and you don't want to leave that place of false security. Then when you're stuck in there, you need to know how to get out of there, how to snap out of it. And the quicker, the easier probably it is, because the longer it will just start on, you know, won't work. And last but not least, know your reward, and don't forget to compliment yourself. So in my case, I've got my business, and then there are my clients. And when I spend a lot of time working with my clients, but especially for my clients, because there are a number of clients I help out by serving as an intermediary. So I make phone calls and I explain to the other parties involved why certain things are necessary for my clients, because one cannot explain it to the other and the other doesn't necessarily understand the first. And quite honestly, it's quite rewarding when I help them out and I can actually see them grow, and not just grow, but finally see that they have a shot in life and actually get to do it and, you know, go to that better place. I mean, that's utterly rewarding. But apart from that, there is also the business side, you know, the part of the marketing, the part where I love to tell my stories and inspire others, do fun things, creative things. And well, sometimes when I've done a lot of phone calls, which are not inspiring, but they are necessary in order to, you know, help my clients move forward and achieve their goals, I can be pretty tired, and especially taking into consideration that I go to the physical therapist twice a week, and occasionally have to deal with my own appointments. I've got surgery coming up. I don't know who's going to do it, and I don't know what they're going to do. I just know it's going to be there somewhere in the future, but that can be pretty draining too. And so my why is that if I don't spend any time on my business, then when I'm done working with those clients, and if I do my job right, that will happen, then there will be no other clients. And besides that, there are so many things I want to do, and I want to do them differently. And so, there's work involved. And anyone who has a business knows what I'm talking about. So that's basically my why. As in my triggers, well, I just talked about them. You know, when I get tired, whether it's mentally or whether it's physically, it does happen. And I need to lay down for a bit. And that's where my challenge comes in, because I'm likely to go into one of my pitfalls. So if I would do it good, I would be, for instance, doing a meditation. But if I'm just giving in, I might go binge watching One Chicago. I'm a big fan of One Chicago. If I make it worse, I'll be playing Sudoku and watching One Chicago. And of course, when I'm playing Sudoku, I'll be missing certain parts, so I need to rewind. And I do have a competitive element in me, which really shows when I'm doing the Sudoku. And of course, I want to do the more difficult ones. And those take up a lot of time. I mean, the easy ones, that's just a few minutes, but the really difficult ones, they are somewhere between, well, I had one which actually took me over a day. Of course, I stopped during the day, but I think it took me like 4 or 5 hours at least. And well, that's not working, because that time could be spent on my business, of course. So it's important to tell myself, hey, get out of there, snap out of it. But how easy is that? And actually, for me, that's one of the most difficult things. So it always helps me to have other accountability partners, as in have people on the outside, like people from mastermind groups, for instance. Maybe people who you tell what you've done. Of course, there's this Gross Day app from Brandon Burchard. I love that app, which keeps popping up, by the way, if their settings are right. But I also came up with a little something else. I call it my virtual accountability partner. It's in my head, but it's a way to snap me right out of it, because once I think about it, then it's like, okay, that's not good if I go there. And there sort of are consequences. They're not actual consequences, but they are mental consequences, because I know that not focusing on the business is not a good thing. And basically, it's having that virtual accountability partner, as I call it, doesn't leave me any room for discussion. I know it's true. I know the other one is right. So I better go do it and get away from it all. And last but not least, there is knowing my rewards. So one of my rewards is, of course, being able to say at the end of the day, yes, I did it, and see the progress I've made. And maybe there was something that's really hard to get to do, and then watching the result, that's always fun. So it's for everyone, you know, all those things can be different. Like for instance, when I talk about the triggers and especially the pitfalls, well, in my case, pitfalls are sort of harmless. I mean, binge watching could be a waste of time. I always try to get something out of those shows. And quite honestly, they've really helped me quite a number of times. I remember that when one of my clients had committed suicide, yeah, I got those clients who can be really depressed. And, you know, they need that push, they need that support to see there's a way out. And unfortunately, this was out of my hands due to a lot of circumstances. And I really had to tell myself that it would have been arrogant to say that I could have been the one to save her. You know, if someone really wants it, and especially when it's attempt 4, 5, 6, or I don't know which one, they will know how to do it. And, you know, it can be a split second and something happens. And yeah. So watching Chicago Fire, for instance, really helped me to realize that I cannot be held accountable for the decision that someone else makes, but also that you cannot save everyone, even if you want to, even if you would try your hardest. It's just not always possible. It's just not. So as for the pitfalls. There are some out there who just don't open their mail anymore. Those don't answer anymore. And then there are some who are likely to use substances, whether it's the green bottles or it's the white powder. You know, it's whatever is present and what you're vulnerable to and what you've been exposed to, especially when you were younger. So when you have easy access to something, whether harmless or the total opposite, that could be your addiction. And you know, for some people it's food, and it at least it's something that instantly makes us feel good. That's for certain. And the other thing is, it takes us away from the pain, so it basically serves as an off switch. And I guess that's the most difficult thing in our current lives. There are so many triggers and there are so many things we are exposed to that we easily can go into that state of mind that says, okay, I'm done with it all, you know, let's just shut off for the day and be done with it. And well, of course, when you need to achieve something, or better yet, when you are the one in control of your business, especially when you have staff, that's no option. You still need to do things. Of course, you can delegate things, but in the end, it's important that you know, whether it's in the background or not, what's actually going on. You know, your staff might need your input. Brainstorm a little bit. Maybe you have some new directions where you want to get the company to. I mean, take a look at this whole COVID thing. I mean, how many companies didn't survive because of COVID? Because, no, well, I don't need to explain why. And last but not least, a lot of people are actually pretty harsh on themselves. So even when they did it good and they held their end of the bargain, as in they did what they needed to do during the day, there's no reward for it. And that's why I just called it the end of the bargain, because that means that there's something on the other side, on the other end. And what's there? What do you do to say, hey, well done, you know? One shoulder, two shoulders. and especially when you're at the top of your company, who's there to say, yeah, well done? And basically that's you. You need to do it yourself. Of course, you will see it once the finances are starting to improve and things are starting to pick up. But still, you know, in between that moment and what you've done, and maybe the results are not showing, but you've made that effort to get there, it's so important that you do reward yourself and perhaps write it down, take a picture, hang it on the wall, whatever it is, you know, just compliment yourself. Well, I'm sure you are dealing with some similar stuff as well. So I'm pretty curious what that would be, and if anything like this resonates with you and you could use a little one-on-one time talking about this, then feel free to hit me up.